Welcome guys. You would have observed the hydraulic turbines which are used for power production. This is one such turbine called Pelton wheel. We all know that the turbine actually converts the hydraulic energy to mechanical energy. It means the energy from the water jet creates a force on the turbine blades. The force then turns out as a torque from the turbine. Let's assume a water jet impinging over a flat, a vertical and stationary blade. I am repeating, it's an assumption. In actual turbine, it's not flat, it's not stationary. Okay, here the fundamental physics stands behind the phenomenon is the force exerted by the jet along the direction x is equal to the rate of change of momentum of the fluid along the direction x. As it is rate of change of momentum, it is a change of momentum divided by the time. Also, we know that the momentum is the mass times the velocity. Now we can take out the mass by time outside the bracket, which is actually the mass flow rate. At this point, we must think of the initial and final velocity of the jet along the direction x. We assume that the initial velocity along the direction as v. And what about the jet velocity after striking? Yes, it is zero because it is completely deflected to y direction. Hence, the initial velocity is v and the final velocity along the direction x is zero. Finally, the force exerted by the jet on a flat stationary plate is equal to rho a v squared. In the next video, we will be discussing the same thing in an inclined plate. Thank you. Don't forget to subscribe.